everybody. This is Jeremy with another edition of Abolitionist Abstractions. So it's been a while since I've done one of these, and I had actually mentioned a couple of weeks ago to a number of people that I was planning on doing one of these on a specific subject, and now I am finally sitting down to do that because I just have oh so much time on my hands. But what I wanted to talk about today was the idea of ostracization, which is something that gets talked about often in the libertarian anarchist circles as a way to, you know, kind of circumvent when people talk about, oh, without government, how do we do this? And how are these things going to be done? And how do we protect ourselves against this? And, you know, we talk about the idea of ostracizing people, you know, working through a reputation-based economy. You know, ideas have been floated about, you know, kind of expanding the way things are done with, you know, Amazon reviews or Yelp or all these different services where people will provide their feedback. So you know, which product or service to use in the future, you know, if you're looking for something and then you see all these, you know, positive reviews from a whole bunch of people, then you're more likely to go use that person. But overall, just, you know, also not just, you know, rewarding the good, but punishing the bad, as it were, in, as far as ostracizing goes, you know, that's often talked about as far as how would you deal with a situation if you have a community with a set, you know, set of rules, you know, assuming that you we're at freedom now and we all have our little communities all over the place and you have an established set of rules. Well, how do you deal with it when somebody breaks the rules repeatedly? You know, and it's often said, oh, we'll just ostracize the person and, you know, they'll be basically, you know, shunned out of the community altogether. And, you know, I'm somebody who has used this argument. I used to rely on it heavily when I first came into anarchism. And when people would ask these questions, that was just my kind of flippant response. Well, of course, we'll handle it this way. Well, fast forward a couple of years, and I've gotten to see how this plays out. And, you know, other people have talked about this. I've actually talked about it on a couple of recent shows. I think we did a Freedom Fiends episode, at least partially on it, a couple of weeks ago. But, you know, it's the idea of, well, we always say, you know, we always say this is how things will work, but let's look at how they actually happen now. And in the liberty-esque community, there are tons of people who attempt to ostracize others. You know, some for ridiculous reasons, others for very valid reasons, as far as I'm concerned. But it doesn't seem to do much because you have people out there that are, well, let's face it, at this point, known scam artists because they've done a number of projects in the past where people have lost a ton of money. And they, you know, these people always seem to come out on the other side with that, you know, who, me? How did this happen? I don't know. Look on their faces. I'm not going to go into too many specific names here, but anybody who follows our community will probably know some of the people I'm talking about here. But there's been a number of people that have been caught either ripping people off in some kind of project or something like that, or not paying people back money, you know, refusing to pay for services, even though, you know, some kind of verbal or written contract was come to beforehand, which again is something we often talk about in our communities about how things are going to move forward. You know, contracts, everything based on contracts. Well, it sounds great, but how does it work in reality? Well, again, you know, when you see these things now, they don't always work so great because there's plenty of people in the liberty movement who I know that have broken contracts, and the attempts to ostracize them seem to backfire because some of these people are just as, if not more, popular than ever. Despite people coming down on them and despite people trying to point out, hey, you know, this guy's a scam artist. He's ripped these people off of money before. Or he did this, or this guy did that, or this guy took some of my services and then just refused to pay me. You know, I've heard plenty of these stories, and yet these people, nothing happens to them. So I guess what I'm really after here is ostracization, you know, that whole idea of ostracizing people out of, you know, shunning them out of community, is that really a feasible thing? Because it sounds great in theory, but we don't seem to be doing much with it here in the present. I mean, it's quite easy for people to jump on a bandwagon and all ostracize somebody who has murdered somebody or raped somebody or, you know, has significant evidence of harming a child or any, you know, anything like that. You know, it's quite easy for everybody to jump on the bandwagon. And I'm not saying it's a bad thing that they do, but, you know, everybody could jump on those bandwagons and say, oh, we hate this person. Oh, let's not, you know, let's not give them our business anymore in whatever shape, form or fashion that that ends up being. But all these other things, you know, fraud, theft, these things happen, you know, violations of contract, which is supposed to be, you know, one of the bedrocks of especially the anarcho-capitalist community. But within that community, and I'm not just singling them out, within all the anarchist communities, there's plenty of people who seem to continue to get away with these bad behaviors, as, you know, bad, I know that's a subjective term, but these negative behaviors that most people seem to view as negative when they talk about them in an abstract, you know, in the abstract. But when you have these people actually doing these things in the present or in the recent past, and you have the evidence and you say, here, look at this, everybody's just like, yeah, we still like the guy, so we're still going to do business with him. It's like, well, that doesn't that just kind of defeat the whole purpose of what we're claiming we're working towards? If we can't even pull it off right now, how is it going to work? So I don't know. Like I said, that's it's been on my mind for a while. I've been meaning to talk about it in a more extended fashion. And right now I'm just kind of like working this over in my own head as I talk into the microphone, because I don't really expect to come up with an answer here. Perhaps those of you who listen to this will have some ideas and can shoot me some feedback and we can discuss it, whether it be through social media, on Steemit, which I now am finally on after resisting it for over a year and a half. I finally have admitted that I was wrong. The project has continued. It's relatively successful, and I should have gotten involved a lot earlier. But anyway, whether it's there or whether you want to sit down and have a chat, do a podcast with me at some point, I'm looking to do that too with people. I'm probably going to be extending abolitionist abstractions to beyond just me talking into a microphone. I'm looking to do some more, you know, sit down conversations with people. Hopefully I can actually do a couple of in-person ones, but you know, through the magic of technology, I have a sit down conversation with some people, just one-on-one type stuff, to kind of keep it separate from the Seeds of Liberty. And also I want to do some more have some more conversations with some people, looking to do some more stuff for our Patreon channel. So, you know, if you want to sit down and have a talk and you're not sure of yourself and you don't necessarily know if you want it going out to everybody, then hey, we could make it a Patreon episode and then it'll only go out to our patrons. But either way, if you have some feedback about this, if you have some ideas, if you think that, you know, ostracizing people is still the best, one of the best methods we have moving forward and it's going to work, then, you know, tell me why. And if you think that you've seen how it hasn't worked in the present, as I have, and you're looking for other possible solutions, then shoot those to me too. But either way, I'd like to continue this conversation on this idea, because like I said, this is something that was, you know, at least for me, very early on, this was one of the first ideas I was introduced to. Probably even before I actually started calling myself an anarchist, I was introduced to the idea of ostracizing people, and that would be how a lot of things would be handled in a quote-unquote free society. And I just kind of mouthed that sentiment for a year or two without really putting much thought into it. And the more I thought about it and the more I saw it in real time around me, where it wasn't exactly working as I thought it would, I've got a few more questions, and I'm just seeking answers. You know, I'm not here to come up with anything definitive. I'm just here to try to pique others' interests and, you know, also keep my own mind moving. So hopefully together we can come up with a better solution. Or we could see if this one actually can still work, and maybe it's just the people that are doing it wrong. Who the hell knows? Anyway, I think that's about all for today. So this has been another episode of Abolitionist Abstractions. I will put a bunch of stuff in the show notes for ways that you can contact me and or donate if you so wish. And otherwise, I'll catch you next time. Peace.